The Premier has slammed calls by the Federal Health Minister to set up school vax clinics to boost immunisation rates and get face masks off young children. But his minister has admitted Victoria's paediatric vaccination rates need to improve. Medical reporter Emily Rice.
On child vaccination policy, the Premier has lambasted the Federal Health Minister.
Frankly, Victorians don't take orders from Greg Hunt, the bloke who forgot to place an order for vaccines.
The stinging rebuke was in response to comments around mask mandates for grade 3 to 6 students. Mr Hunt suggested the face covering edict could be dropped if vax rates improved through a jabs in schools rollout.
The fastest way out is to have a school-based vaccination program.
During the summer holidays, state government immunisation pop-ups did operate on school grounds.
I got a WhatsApp message from the Prime Minister like the day after I made those announcements saying it was one of the best things he'd ever heard. It was terrific. Well done.
And while 94% of Victorians over 12 have had 2 COVID vaccine doses...
When it comes to 5 to 11-year-olds, not quite 1% are double vaxxed.
There are just under 7,000 new COVID cases and 319 hospitalisations. Despite the numbers, Professor Fiona Russell of the Murdoch Children's Research Institute says mask rules for little ones need to go.
It should be removed now. There's really no reason for it. Children communicate and learn better when they can see someone's facial expressions.
Special clinics for vulnerable children are popping up too. Last weekend at Legoland Chadstone and this weekend at Hillsville Sanctuary and Werribee Zoo. Appointments are invitation only.
There's no doubt the COVID vaccine drive among the 5 to 11-year-old age group has been slower than in older populations. Child health experts are meeting now to discuss how to ramp up the take-up.
Emily Rice, Nine News.
Queensland continues to move through the tail of the Omicron wave, the numbers holding steady and hospitalisations falling dramatically since the peak last month. Peter Fegan has the latest.
Well, Queensland's COVID numbers continue to be steady. We saw a drop in the case numbers overnight. There were 6,094 new infections in the last 24 hours. That's down from 6,301 yesterday. Sadly, though, another 8 Queenslanders lost their lives, 4 of whom were in aged care. The numbers in school-aged children continues to be a concern, with 1,924 additional positive cases. But the hospital rate is in a steady decline. Just 1 month ago, Queensland reached its hospital peak of 928 patients. In stark contrast, today, that there are just 334 patients needing care across the state system. That's down almost 600 patients. Very positive signs for the state, just 8 days out from the largest easing of restrictions we will see here since the pandemic began.
And a brand new COVID-19 saliva test is looking to change the game from the usual PCR and rapid antigen tests. Currently under development right here in Queensland, the test seeks to determine how sick you'll get if you contract the virus.
Our study actually found that this test detects the body's response to infection.
The test can also be used to detect if you are COVID positive.